Hi all, this is Simone and Rich, and in this video I would like to comment on one of the things that Jim Carrey said, which is, I don't remember exactly the quote, but it goes something like that in the past he thought he's a guy experiencing the world and the universe, but now it feels like the world and the universe is experiencing the guy. And this is a very significant quote, and it will be understood only by those who experienced it. What happened to him is total disidentification from the body. He understood himself to be the universe. When I was meditating one time, that was when I was renting a house in India, I felt like I'm the whole universe. According to Buddhism, this is the first material absorption that happens to you. And there are three more to go. If I'm not mistaken, the next absorption is unlimited consciousness, so you will feel like you're unlimited consciousness. I have not experienced it. I have no idea how it feels like, but I know what it feels, that you are the feeling yourself as unlimited universe. So the second non-physical absorption is feeling yourself to be unlimited consciousness. The third, nothingness. And the fourth, neither nothingness nor existence, or something like this. I don't exactly remember the name for that last absorption, and after it there's nothing more to achieve according to Buddhism. So it seems, and I cannot know for sure, but it seems that Jim Carrey certainly achieved the first non-physical absorption. And when I was in Thailand, I tried to pierce through that other unlimited consciousness realm, but I was not able to do so. But hopefully I will be able to accomplish this. And this disidentification from the body happens as a result of meditation and yoga. And some people experience it without even doing these practices. For example, Eckhart Tolle experienced it just out of nowhere. He was so burdened by his unhappy mind, and something just happened to him and he became detached. But usually this detachment can be achieved only through practices such as Eastern esoteric practices of yoga and meditation. So when you start meditating, things that you used to think to be important no longer seem so. And even Jim Carrey says that he sees people playing roles, and it's just a role, and it's just mental construct, what you know about yourself. How do you even know about things that happened in the past without your consciousness? Someone else told you. And so this whole story is starting to be weaved, and this reality becomes so strong. But I was also thinking, I meditate every day, and usually since I try to be conscious all the time, I dream in a conscious way also. And I was thinking, in kind of semi-conscious way, to be more exact. And I was thinking that there is no difference between this reality and dreams. There is absolutely, there's almost no difference. The only difference is that in this reality, characters tell you who you are. So your parents told you the name that you were born, and so you know the past. And in my experience, in dreams, you don't get, they don't look so, that reality of dreams don't look so real, doesn't look so real, because nobody tells you that you have this name, you're born here, your mother is that, your father is that. Nobody tells you that, but consciousness still is completely in the play. So in the dream, you just start from some event and then it just goes on, and consciousness is completely identified with that time, what's happening, and you're not asking how did I end up here. You don't have those kind of questions. You just do what you're supposed to do. So the same would be in this reality also. The only difference is that someone tells you that you were born, your name is that. And this also reminds me of another guru, Indian guru that I used to listen to. If I am not mistaken, his name is Nisargadatta Maharaj or Maharaj or something like this. He was a very well-known guru compared even to Sri Ramana Maharishi, because he was believed to be a saint. So he used to tell that as well, and I did not understand that time, but now I do, that he told that, how do you know this reality is true? It's because someone tells you that you were born, that this is your name, and this reality seems so real because of that. But if nobody would tell you, and you just grow up without the speech, because speech also entraps us, and words in this written language entrap us, and animals are not trapped in this way because they don't have that. But if you're just like a baby, developing, and nobody is telling you who you are, so then you would be just experiencing this world without even consciousness of yourself. But someone tells you who you are, and interestingly, it was told in some cultures there are obviously written records that explain that gods gave us language, that gods gave us the written word, and this kind of is one of the building blocks of the matrix. That's what entraps us. If there wouldn't be any language, we would experience the world like we would be like the universe experiencing the world through us. But because of someone is told us who we are, they expect us to behave in a certain way, and so we become trapped as these individuals, and we no longer feel our unlimited natures. And Jim Carrey broke out of it. So it's interesting, because when I started listening to him after his change, I wasn't sure about his change, but it seems that it's genuine and that he definitely experienced that awakening, because it's exactly the other way around, as he told, that before he was just a guy experiencing the universe, and now the universe is experiencing the guy. So that's an awakening. So that's something to think about. I don't want to keep this video long. I hope that you will think about this interesting subject. Because we do indeed, the more we grow, the more limited usually people become, but it's possible to undo that through meditation and yoga, so that you understand that you're not this limited human being, but you're much more than that, and that actually this body is not your own anyway. And Buddhists know that as well, because if this body would indeed be your own, you would be able to control it, but you cannot control it. You cannot control diseases. You cannot control the aging. The hair will get gray whether you want it to happen or not. This body belongs to this universe. It's part of it, like we see flowers growing and dying. And so people also grow and die. These bodies belong to this particular earth nature, but we are not that. So meditation, yoga help to disidentify from this body, and then you will understand that you're much greater, much more than this physical body, and then your worries will be gone. And Jim Carrey also says that he is no longer feeling the same way that he felt before. There are no longer such human moods, kind of I think he said that he still experiences some moods, but it's just it belongs to the body. And I agree with that, like the same, like on this earth we experience rain and thunder, so it's like anger and tears, they just happen. It's just the process. It keeps body mechanism healthy, but you're not identified with that. And I recently read a good book of one Buddhist monk who experienced amazing developments. So that holy man also was accused that he did not actually achieve enlightenment because he cried, and people did not understand how enlightened people could cry. But the tears belong to the body. You still have the body, you don't lose the body after enlightenment. And I read the middle length discourses of Buddha, and he also it was written that he got tired, or like he had back pain, and so he lied down. So you don't become superhuman after you get enlightened, and you do experience emotions, but you know that they are not your emotions, that the body goes through those processes. So when you experience this kind of awakening, most of your worries are gone. I could say all of your worries are gone, because you're no longer like a human being, because you know you're not this body, so you cannot identify with other people. You know that you're greater than the body, that you're experiencing this universe through this body. So I do believe that Jim Carrey went through some sort of awakening, and if we don't see any more change back, then it means that awakening was genuine. So that's very interesting, and I hope that you will think about the words that he said, that he no longer thinks himself a person experiencing things, experiencing the universe, but that the universe experiences the body. So something to think about. That's all I wanted to share with you. Thank you for watching.